It's just hard to let go of this place that was home for so long.
This has been one of the most satisfying, rewarding, and stimulating times of my life.
I've grown in my confidence, in my ability to impact the world.
Yeah, it was definitely hard at the beginning, but I don't regret any of it.
When I first came for visit weekend, I felt this aura of welcome from the department. Welcome to our community, and we want you here and we want you to flourish. While the advisor relationship is one of the most important ones for your success in graduate school, at the beginning it can be a really confusing time. It's really this process of trying to match interest, advisor, funding, lab group, community.
I think it's one of the hardest processes at MIT that no one really talks about. Really ask what you want out of the MIT ecosystem and know that you own this journey. You own every part of it. Everyone wants to see you succeed, and you need to know what that means. You need to know what success is.
The key was finding an advisor and a lab that just worked for me.
I think one of the important things about MIT is that it's a place where ideas are welcomed, not just about your area of research, but also about making MIT as a whole better. I've been pretty vocal on DEI issues, and I questioned our commitment to dismantling racial inequalities, but also inequalities that are detrimental to people's success. I know that these grievances have been fully recognized. They put in money, they put in time, they put in effort, they bring in experts. They want to come up with a plan that actually works for everyone.
Quals, our qualifying exams, is challenging, and it changes who you are and also how you see yourself.
I can remember that being definitely one of the most stressful times of my life, thinking whether or not I'm good enough to be here.
The first time I took quals, I failed my subject exams, but I got a second chance. And a big part of that for me was learning how to really confidently justify my knowledge on the board. The MECI department were somewhat unique and maybe have a reputation for being distinctly hard because we do oral exams. And while it's maybe extra intimidating and hard to do oral exams, I actually think it's such an important skill set to being successful in the world. Many people feel imposter syndrome. Not passing quals the first time can also add to that. And it meant a lot to me to hear a professor who I respected tell me, no, you belong here. This is a great opportunity to continue to grow and develop those skill sets.
It really feels like people care about you and they care about your progress and your PhD, and they will really check in on you and just see how you're doing, how your research is doing, how your classes are doing, so you never feel like alone.
I've spent some time reflecting on what it means to leave well. One part of that is kind of the final rite of passage, the defense. And that's really formulated based around your contributions to science. So while some parts of the PhD process can be lonely or very focused by yourself, the defense is this moment of coming together and sharing. There's this magic to being in person and having your community there and really celebrating the work that you've done. I'm so thankful for my time here in the Mechanical Engineering Department.
It's honestly been one of the best experiences of my life.
I wouldn't trade this for anything in the world.